Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be introducing you to our new product, Unity Reflect, and then what you can do when you build on it with the Unity Editor. This is Christopher Gonzalez. I'm coming to you from our headquarters in San Francisco. So with that, let's dive right in. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen from my laptop here. And I have this client of Revit open. What we're looking at is a very basic and baked-in model that comes with Revit. Where we're going to go now is our 3D view. Make sure that's selected. And then go ahead, once that is, to our Unity tab, now that Reflect has been installed as a plugin. We're going to go ahead and start that export process. I'm going to make sure that I'm logged in up here to my users. I'm going to do it on a local host server. And then I'm going to choose an existing project. You could have the option here to create a new one. So let's go ahead and export that. You'll see it working down here on the left. It's going to print it out. Right now, it's just taking all of that BIM-rich data, and it's going to push it out to the Reflect viewer. You also have the option here to go ahead and go into the Unity Editor and start building onto all of the data that was exported. But before that, we're going to go into our Unity Reflect viewer. This viewer is a free-to-download client that can be used by anyone that's on your collaboration team, your clients, any stakeholders. They're free to download this on mobile, laptop, desktop, and take a part in the design collaboration process. So let's go ahead and open that file. And there we have it, right away it built up, it took all of the information from Revit, and we're looking at the live model now. So I'm gonna go over some of the features that Unity Reflect offers with the out-of-the-box viewer. The first thing I wanna point out here is this category tree menu. So we can go in here and really isolate certain items or turn certain items on or off. For example, if we wanted to look at the roof, just the roofs and the materials that lie there. Make sure that the windows are installed right. Make sure that anything that you have going on in your design is visible. We can do that here. We can also turn the roofs completely off. So say you're using another feature of Reflect, which is our multi-user federation, and you have your mechanical, electrical, plumbing files coming here. You wanna make sure there's no crash or collision going on. You also wanna make sure that for construction, everything is in line and where it needs to be. So this is a very useful out-of-the-box tool of Unity Reflect. The next thing I want to demonstrate here is our live sync. So these two arrows, I'm going to go ahead and activate that. And so now, if I go back to the Revit model, and I zoom in a little bit here, I'm going to show you just a very basic example of how this works. I move my window over to the left a little bit, or the right rather, and right away, before I could even come back to Reflect, the change has taken place. And so as you can imagine, I'm gonna go ahead and put it back. This could be used for material changes. If you're testing out different manufacturers, particularly let's say your lighting manufacturers, you wanna see what different objects or lights or furniture looks like. Live Sync is a great tool to be able to demonstrate that, especially with the viewer being free. Anyone in the room downloading this and viewing this can take a look at your live changes from Revit. So let's go ahead and disengage that. And the next thing is probably one of the most exciting. It's out-of-the-box VR and AR activation. So because I'm on a laptop right now, the menu button there will think that I have the possibility to have an HTC Vive and many other headsets coming up in the future to be used for VR. But I'm going to switch over to my iPad now so that we can see what the menu actually looks like when we view this from a mobile device. So let's open our Unity Viewer, Reflect Viewer, look at the same model. And now you'll notice that instead of the VR, we have tabletop AR mentioned. So if we select that, we'll get these nice tracking arrows to place right here on the table. And if I hit the check mark, yes, right there it is, there's our model. We can rotate, we can pinch zoom, we can fit this to scale. And now that we're in AR, I can actually walk around the room with my iPad and go into anywhere in the house. I'm gonna go right here into the balcony, go through the window. I'm gonna turn around and look back out the window. I wanna pull up. Basically, I can lower the iPad and then look down and go anywhere I want, really. AR is really powerful for this effect. So let's go ahead and turn that off. Bring this back. Now, what I've just shown you are some really great features of Unity Reflect and its viewer. Now, what we want to actually demonstrate here to even empower that is what you can build on top of the viewer. And so because Unity itself is a game engine, and we can create all sorts of real-time rendering situations, you can create your own custom applications. What I want to do next is show you what you can do when building on top of what you've already imported with Reflect. So I'm going to share back from my laptop again. And here I'm going to open up a custom Reflect viewer. Right away, it's going to look very similar to the last viewer that we were just looking at, but there are some subtle and major differences. The first being is that the camera pan has been reduced. So maybe for a client review, if they're not so familiar with how to navigate and use the flyby camera, the quick rotation of the normal speed of the viewer may be too fast for them. The next thing that we wanted to add here for an architectural example and construction specifically in this feature is a timeline. So think of a digital and visualization Gantt chart. We can assign a time and date to every piece of the structure that's going to build here, and we can realize the construction of that over time. And this is really great, especially if you're using AR out in the field and you want to line up your day with your schedule and your construction workers and people who are actually building this. They want to see the right sequence of how things are meant to be placed and put. This is fantastic for that. The other feature we added was a very intuitive camera menu navigation pane. So if I want to go right into the living room, my one click will bring me right there. And I've also disabled the ability to fly up and down. So I can look around, I can look left and right, up and down, but I can't actually float up and down. So I can't get lost in the space. I'm centered here, and that's just a parameter that we set to make ease of viewing. Another really great feature we added to some of these rooms is taking the BIM data from Revit and on a click of the furniture, having that material property visible, manufacturer properties visible. You can also add pricing if you wanted to, lead times, anything you want here, really. So this is really great for design collaboration and maybe with your end user trying to get a good idea of what's going to go into this space and what they could change and maybe what they might not want or what they like. So closing that menu then brings you back to your normal camera control, and then you can fly back out and resume normal control. So these two buttons are not part of Unity Reflect normally. Again, we added these in the Unity editor as part of our core product, and we created something that was applicable to an architectural product deliverable. So I hope this has all been very useful, and I hope you're excited to try Unity Reflect. And if you are, we're offering some trial periods right now, so please reach out. My name is Christopher. We hope to hear from you soon.